Hey everyone, it's what? Wednesday, the 26th of Feb, 2020. Just in my up on the beach, just the river's right down there. And man, did it change the beach. Like it's flowing this way, like down the beach way. So I don't know if it's gonna be able to build the sand back up. We're gonna need a couple of no rain days and just to build the berm back up. That's what happens. I don't know what's going to happen in Montanita. I was there yesterday and all three rivers punched through. The big river, and there was two really small like streams, you know, trickle streams. They had a bit of a, you know, they had a flow pattern area, but you know, nothing ever flowed. But when that rain came the other night at 12 hours, it just, like I was talking to people, and it just literally punched through. Yeah, like, the river's coming all the way down. You see Buddy on the motorcycle? He's right in there. I hope he makes it. Okay. He was losing his motorcycle in the sand there. Holy shit, as the water was going by, it was just washing the sand out from underneath us. So it was like trying to pull something at a quicksand. You should have come right here. There's nothing. He decided to cross in a really deep area. Holy shit. Oh. Well, there was my cardio, or my lack thereof. When I force like that, I don't breathe. Bad habit. I'm breath hold the grunter in the gym. Bad habit. But what do I want to talk about today? You know, the internet's finally cooperating, so I can get some video watching in. It's really hard to upload videos. Takes like a whole night to upload video, so it's really frustrating. So tonight I'll upload a couple of videos. Maybe it's getting better. So, but yeah, coronavirus. And once again, I just reiterate, the narrative doesn't matter whether it's be real or not. You know, like I said, if somebody goes running through a theater screaming fire, 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 whether it's real or not, people are going to get injured getting out of the theater. You know? Something's going to happen. People are going to exit. People are not going to exit. People may get trampled. People may not hear it. You know, it's just... So, you know, like with all the amount of information we got out there, you know, I don't know what to make of this coronavirus. All I know is that the powers that be, whomever that may be, whoever you want to brand as your enemy number one, if that's the case, they don't let anything go to waste. So, you know, good tragedy or good, you know, whatever, to roll out a new agenda. So, for me, the narrative doesn't matter. The agenda is going forward. Whatever, you know, they've decided that, okay, we only need 600 million on the planet to sustain the planet and to sustain, you know, our way of life. You know, I'm not talking about your way of life. I'm talking about their way of life. Don't be confused. Their way of life is to put you and your family into indentured slavery for the rest of your days till time gone by, like in the Old Testament and all that, like, you know, Egyptians and the Hebrews, then that's the way it's going to be, you know. Or we can go Star Trek and we can say, okay, the aliens have landed a while ago, and in order to take over the Earth, they have to whittle us down and get us to the point where, you know, like any other good sci-fi dystopia, is where the aliens come in unknowingly to us, beat us down, And then, you know, we rise up and then we take back or whatever, but only under the guise that they're still in charge and we think that we're starting over again or whatever. Or, you know, we start stealing from our own planet, but, you know, and or then they just show up and say, oh, wow, what a tragedy you were bombarded by. I'll use the Star Trek one. Alien race bombards a planet with asteroids to devastate the planet and then show up later on to take over. Oh, your planet's devastated by all these asteroids. Hey, guess what? We got all kinds of technology, blah, blah, blah. We'll feed your population. But, you know, Earth is our... Look, being a jerk. Yes. Because the narrative, what I say, doesn't matter. What's going forward is going forward. People can scream and yell about whistleblowers and telling the truth and telling lies, but it doesn't matter. The agenda goes forward. Look at Assange. Look at what's going on in the world, and you can just see that the agenda goes forward. It doesn't matter. So, I'm in tune with a lot of people on YouTube. You know, take care of yourself. Take care of your family. Take care of your immediate circle around you would probably be your best thing. Yes, of course. Think about the long term. Like, I'm not going to go home and start burying plastic and, you know, not care or start looting or start, you know, killing all my neighbors because I want all their resources. No, that's not how it works for me. But this corona thing, the beer virus, you know, it's been moving steady since 2001, pretty much. You know, maybe a little bit earlier than that. You know, whatever the agenda, whenever it started. You know, maybe back in the 90s, back in the 80s. I don't know, I'm not sure. You know, like I said, I only started following politics relatively when, you know, in the 80s, kind of sort of 70s, 80s, you know, and I was a teenager, right? So, these agendas are long. You know, they're... I think, you know, 100-year agendas, you know, like almost like 200-year lifetime agendas, maybe. You know, how do we want to see America? You know, when the people were in 1776 said, in 200 years, how do we want our country to be? Let's make a path, a plan. And relatively, those who had started the country are relatively in a good way still today. So you got to look at it that way, right? The empire may fall. But the individuals that have, you know, taken pieces or garnered whatever from it are okay. You know what I mean? Like, you look at all the criminal families, you know, that made their day and, you know, during Prohibition or whatever, what have you. They're doing okay. You know? It's unbelievable. You know, I was looking at this woman, Elizabeth Holm, who is an absolute sociopath, psychopath, criminal, bereft of any humanity, like knowingly lying and stuff like that about her product, but not caring one iota. You know, just like that Wolf of Wall Street scumbag. I read up on him because I was wondering, you know, if I'd seen the movie, and well, the movie was great, the whole subject matter was reprehensible. But I read up on this guy today, and he still has lots of money. He still lives way better than you and I would ever live. So yeah, he paid back supposedly all the monies that he had stolen. You see what I mean? You see what I mean? You know, people probably killed themselves because of this guy. Families were probably destroyed because of this guy. You know, and nothing. 22 months in jail, and that's what I mean. So, you know, I'm sorry, I'm a little bit rambly. You know, I'm off on the subject of this guy, but you know, Elizabeth Holm and that. But it's all tied in to the maid families, to the criminal organization families that run the planet, you know, the ones that are made people. Just look up affluency defense. Oh, my kid can't go to jail because we're so rich we didn't teach him right. Come on. Anyway, yeah, thanks a lot for all the comments lately. Appreciate it. Yeah, Alan, I was 6 feet back from that bank. I wasn't gonna fall in it. I didn't want to because I just had a vision of the whole thing just getting swept out and it was moving pretty fast, so I'd have sure lost my camera. You know, I'd have been soaking wet. Goodness knows what was in that water, you know, logs and rocks and that. But no, and just an observation, while I'm thanking everybody for the comments and the new subscribers. want to welcome everybody. A guy made a comment, or a person made a comment, sorry, on my channel. My dream was the channel name. I tried to investigate, you know, it's like, hey man, you know, love your content, subscribe to your channel, blah, blah, blah. Subscribe to my channel. I always do that. I sub for sub. If you sub me, I sub you back. Doesn't matter. You know, if you have content, then I'll go watch it. But I go to, you know, reply to the guy's comment or go to try and find his channel. So you know that notification thing, the bell or whatever? When you used to be able to click on it, you'd click on whatever was you were notified about. And it would take you to your page and take you right to the comment and wouldn't play the video. So I'm like, okay, I noticed that that's not the same anymore. So I try and find this guy's comment, doesn't exist. You know, a couple people made comments on the video, those showed up. So I try and find this guy's comment, try and go to my own video, find the guy's comment that way. Now I'm going through YouTube Studio, couldn't find it there. You know, I go to comments, doesn't exist. Then I go to, maybe it's a spam, you know, maybe it's been misidentified as spam. Nope, not in there. Something approved, nope, not in there either. Try and find his channel, can't find it. You know, there's a whole bunch of my dream channel, just like there's a whole bunch of Michaels out there. You know, but my original name was Blunt Trauma 621. So forever I'm like, okay, so I have somebody who made a comment. I cannot see it anywhere. I know the comment's there, I can see it in my notification. But I can't find it or anything. And this just makes me think that I'm in a YouTube area. Like I'm in a different zone of YouTube. I go to social, just for shits and giggles, go to Social Blade and type in my name. And you'll look at some of my videos, 200, 300 views, maybe 400. And I look at the video on my page and I get like 20 views. So I'm like, okay, where's all my views going for one? You know, like, is YouTube being mismanaged so badly that, you know, us here in the basement just are to ourselves and the ones who get stolen from content, and because we're not big enough that, you know, people just steal our content. Like, I don't know why anybody would steal this content, but there may be some, like my Sergeant Lois video would be one to steal because it's garnered almost 250,000 views. And it is it's a good video. I mean, it's Emery, R. Lee, you know, from his, not Full Metal Jacket, the other one, Boys in Company C. I got a copyright for Full Metal, but I didn't get a copyright for Boys in Company C, so don't know why that is. But anyway, so, you know, we know they don't play fair. I just wanted to mention that because, like, I'm like, has that happened to you? You see the comment, you want to reply to the comment, you try and find the comment, you try and find the channel, and you just nothing. It's as if, you know, it's in the cloud. It's a cloud comment. Doesn't exist, really. Anyway, wow, what a difference, eh? Wednesday today, Carnival is officially over. Apologies all around, no foam wars. Just didn't happen this year, you know, it's happened before. If you want to see a good one, you'll have to go back and watch it where I've got my camera strapped to my foam container bag. I think it's like 3 years ago we did that one. Maybe four, I don't know. Sometimes it just doesn't work out, you know, did a lot of hanging out with the family, you know, hanging out in Mangler Alto, because it's Mangler Alto starting to grow now, and less as Mangler Alto grows, I'll be coming into Montanita less and less, because, you know, Montanita's fun, don't get me wrong, you know, a lot of things to go on in Montanita, a lot of, you know, things to do, coffee to drink, it's got the gym, but Mangler Alto is my bedroom community that I live in. I want to start taking advantage of all the things that they have to offer there. You know, because as it grows, you want to support your community, right? You know. Anyway, standard fare, off to the gym, get some ceviche.
Wow, man, I totally threw my back out helping that guy with the motorcycle. I didn't realize it until I got to the gym. But I was doing a lot of, you know, that you're just pulling and you're reefing, and I had my back bent over, so I'm sore. But I can't see somebody struggling, man, like that. It was pathetic. I thought for sure the guy's motorcycle was gonna go over. Anyway, I'm glad I was able to help him. Because there was nobody around. The cop just drove right by. Oh. I have no words to describe how good this is. I don't need to tell you. You know it's good. I mean, I'm here almost, I'm here every day. You can ask these guys. The crazy Canucks always here.
BC North, talk down the flip side.